justice, no peace. The U.S. have a Middle East, no justice, no peace. The U.S. have a Middle East, no justice, no peace. The U.S. have a Middle East, no justice, no peace. The U.S. have a Middle East.
Shame on Schumer! Shame on Schumer! Shame on Schumer! Shame on Schumer! Shame on Schumer!
Shame on Schumer! Shame on Schumer!
We as Afghan Americans, we have one foot in Afghanistan. We have family there, we have relatives, we have friends, but we're also uniquely positioned as Americans to fight for policy on behalf of the Afghan people. We are working with various senators, congressional folks, across Washington, D.C., so that we can hope and plead to get Afghanistan and specifically Kabul airport secure. We are hoping that the Biden administration takes this seriously because time is of the essence. There are U.S. citizens that cannot get out. There are folks with SIV visas, P1, P2 visas that still cannot get out because the security at Kabul airport is so abysmal. And so we have our demands that specifically call for Biden and administration to increase the security around Kabul airport immediately. We also have demands that processing of any pending visas is expedited. We also demand that humanitarian parole is also offered to all Afghan refugees. As of this moment in time, there is no time for processing stuff. There is no time for the United States to wait any longer. Any Afghan that wants to leave Afghanistan should have every right to do so. And lastly, we are calling on the United States and allies to ensure that there's a humanitarian aid package so that those that cannot leave Afghanistan are not forgotten about and have a chance to live. I have relatives across the country. The ones that are not in Kabul, in the capital, have essentially given up in terms of trying to leave the country. My relatives that are in Kabul are desperately trying to leave. They are cleared to leave. They're a U.S. citizen, they're a legal permanent resident, and they're visa holders. So they have every right and every avenue, supposed avenue, to reach the United States. But because Kabul airport is such a mess, there's no security, the Taliban are literally not letting people through. They're beating people, they're shooting at people, they're literally grabbing people. There's just no way to leave the country. And so my family was outside of the Kabul airport for over 36 hours. And this is a family with children, this is a family with young ones, with elderly, that had to sit outside, no water, no food, because they don't want to get lost and separated, and still they were not get through. The only thing that they did receive were beatings by the Taliban. And now they're in hiding for fear that the Taliban might find out that they tried to leave the country. And so I cannot, I don't know how many other ways to say that the situation is incredibly dire. The United States has a responsibility to get these folks out. So you can actually go to this congressional call script with a shortened link. It's a bit.ly link, bit.ly/call4AFG. And so anybody can go there and they can get all of this information immediately.
Give us a black Afghanistan! Give us a black Afghanistan!